Spokesperson for the UN Agency for Palestinian Louise Wateridge Refugees says that amid relentless Israeli airstrikes and expanding ground operations, Palestinians in Gaza are increasingly forced to live among the rubble of destroyed buildings. In an X post, she said that many Palestinians begin their day by checking if their loved ones are still alive and end it hoping to survive the night. As Israeli forces continue their invasion of Khan Younis and Deir el-Balah, the military has released footage of a tunnel being demolished and reported clashes with Palestinian fighters. In a deadly airstrike on the Austrian Towers area, 5 Palestinians were killed, and many others wounded. In one Israeli attack, a Palestinian journalist was shot while covering the expanding ground invasion in southern Gaza. The human toll of Israel's war on Gaza continues to climb, with at least 40,139 people killed and 92,743 wounded. Meanwhile, the Palestine Red Crescent Society marked World Humanitarian Day by honoring the 21 members of its team who lost their lives in the conflict, emphasizing the need to protect humanitarian workers. Hamas also issued a statement calling for international action against Israel's racist and criminal practices against humanitarian aid teams and urged global efforts to support Palestinians in the besieged enclave. In diplomatic developments, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken renewed support for Israel during a meeting with President Isaac Herzog in Tel Aviv, while emphasizing the importance of finalizing a ceasefire agreement to allow humanitarian aid and stabilize the region. Meanwhile, Jordan's Foreign Minister Ayman Safadi reiterated the urgent need for a ceasefire to prevent further escalation, warning that failure to act would only lead to more death and destruction. In a significant development, the Supreme Court of Pakistan suspended the Islamabad High Court's IHC orders in the audio leaks case involving Bushra Bibi, wife of former Prime Minister Imran Khan, and Najm Saqib, son of former Chief Justice Saqib Nisar. The court expressed concerns over the IHC's jurisdiction and sought records from the federal government while restraining further action on the case. Meanwhile, former Prime Minister Imran Khan, currently imprisoned, has applied for the prestigious position of Chancellor at the University of Oxford. His application is seen as a bold move despite his ongoing legal battles in Pakistan. If selected, Khan would become the first Chancellor of Asian descent at the renowned university, a significant achievement as he marks 1 year in prison. In Balochistan, devastating monsoon rains have resulted in the deaths of 16 people and damaged thousands of homes, roads, and bridges. The provincial government has declared an emergency in several districts, as Pakistan continues to grapple with the ongoing impact of climate change. Relief efforts are underway as authorities work to manage the widespread destruction caused by the rains. Finally, YouTuber Aun Ali, who was allegedly abducted on August 15, has returned home safely. His release followed a court order demanding his recovery by August 20. The case highlighted concerns over enforced disappearances in Pakistan, particularly targeting individuals engaged in satirical or critical content. Human rights groups have expressed alarm at the pattern of abductions, urging an end to these unlawful practices. Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov has accused the US of ordering the 2022 attacks on the Nord Stream gas pipelines, calling it a terrorist act that required a command from the top. However, he didn't provide clear evidence to support his claim. The US has previously denied any involvement. Meanwhile, German prosecutors have issued an arrest warrant for a Ukrainian man suspected of involvement in the blasts. In other news, Russia's defense ministry announced that its troops have captured the town of Artemovo in Ukraine's eastern Donetsk region. The region has seen intense combat for 2.5 years, with Ukraine facing challenges in holding the front line due to manpower and ammunition shortages. The World Health Organization has reported a record 1,940 attacks on healthcare services in Ukraine since Russia's offensive began, resulting in 166 deaths and 514 injuries. The United Nations has condemned the increasing violence against humanitarian workers, with 280 killed worldwide in 2023. The conflict in Gaza may lead to even higher numbers of deaths this year.